Hello, Internet. James Allen from Out of 8, and today I'm playing first-person shooter Day of Infamy. This game started out as a mod for Insurgency. It's actually by the same developers, but it's kind of morphed into a full-fledged release. And as you'll see with the weapons and map design, I think it is worth a full release price. Game features primarily multiplayer is what the focus is, so I really want you to play online with other people. Has cooperative missions you can undertake, and also assault, defense, and area control type missions. I'm going to do practice games against the AI to do two things. One is to show off the quality of the bots, and the other one is so I don't completely embarrass myself against the talented people that are online. Game features 10 maps. Each of the maps are very detailed, most of which take place in at least partially an urban environment, covering the Western Front of World War II, so you'll get the Germans against either the Americans, British, or Canadians in some cases. So I'm going to do a couple of the missions here. I think I'll start out with Sicily. You do have cooperative missions, which are actually pretty fun online. You get up to 8 human players taking on a much larger bot army, where it becomes very challenging because although the bots can be good in engaging you, especially if they're masked up, they do sometimes just ignore you or miss you, and as you'll see when we start playing against them. You can also have battles, attack, defense, or taking over certain points on the map. And then it's shorter things, which are round-based firefights and stuff like that, where you're just trying to control like a couple points, or sabotaging a blowing up something, or delivering intelligence across the map. So I'm going to do a frontline mode here. We'll increase the number of bots here in a little bit. Alright, so I'm going to play both sides eventually, but I'm going to start out with the Germans, I think, and pick their kind of default person here. There are different classes in the game. They're the same for both sides, although they have different region-specific names. You have the officer that can call in fire support, which is probably what I'll do first. He needs to have a radio person next to him in order to call it in. You have the regular rifleman. You have the attack assault person with a submachine gun. Get your support person with a light machine gun. Flamethrowers are fun. You get an engineer, which can have explosives, which are needed for some of the objectives. You get a heavy machine gunner that has to use their bipod in order to shoot. There's no shooting standing up with that guy, so it's really useful for defensive missions. And then you get your sniper. So I'll start out with the officer. Just like in Insurgency, you get a certain number of supply points, which you can spend on weapons and also upgrading your weapons if desired, however you want to allocate your points. Probably use that. You get a couple of grenades here. You can do smoke grenades or explosives. Get my binoculars for free because I'm an officer. You can get heavier kits for more weapons and stuff like that, and your knife. So I will do that. And we'll begin here as soon as it loads all the bots in. So in this mode here, you're supposed to capture the intermediate points and then blow up the radio tower at the end. You get a limited number of waves in order
Jungs,
to do so.
Wir verschieben die Linie, und zwar heute noch. Viel zu lang schon bewegt sich hier gar nichts. Nehmt eure Funkgeräte und Ausrüstung. Wir machen Druck nach vorne und zerstören ihre Kommunikation. Verjagt diese Arschlöcher aus unserem Sektor.
Here we go.
Beeilung, Bewegung.
So I'm going to run out to try to radio in some support, because I know basically where the Americans are going to start showing up. The weapons are actually pretty well balanced in the game. The short-range weapons aren't very useful at long-range and vice versa. There's a lot of tension also with how... let me get the radio in here.
Wer hat ein Funkgerät? Zu mir damit!
There's a cooldown timer on this. So I'm gonna try to call in some support. That'll do an explosive
blast. Blast the Arschlöcher weg! Schick
Artillerie! so they will set some explosives there. Which is too bad I won't be able to see it, because it just died. But that's alright. Oh no, I can hear him. Let's see if we can pick somebody that's in that area up. Yeah, please capture the area while I'm on fire. Good job, Jim. So, that's basically what the officer can do. I'll switch to the assault class here, get an MP40. You can switch classes. There's a limit on how many special classes you can have per game. In something like this, I like to be assault. You get to be a little bit more offensive. And with the short engagement ranges on this map, usually pays to have a submachine gun. I'm going to start running into trouble real quick.
Geht mit Deckung, Jungs. Ich lade nach.
Teammates are not doing very good. Me neither. So, the pace of the game is a lot like Insurgency, where it's 1-2 shot kills. Generally fast paced until you reach where you think the enemy's going to be, and then you kind of want to slow down because there's no crosshairs for hip firing. So you really want to fire down the sights. Like I said earlier, the weapon balance is pretty good. There's the bots not recognizing they're right next to each other. You know, you can't... The bolt-action rifles are good at distance, but not really good close up. And that's conversely related. You know, the machine guns are really good at suppression, but then you don't really want to use them in an attack. Same thing with the sniper rifles. They're good if you have a good position to fire them from, but then if you're stuck in a building, it's not really that as effective there. Let's see if we can capture that. Let's see here.
Move it! Get in there!
Gottverdammt! Verdammt! Bestätige! Er ist tot! Handgranaten raus!
That was a good grenade if they ignore it. Back here. I'm getting kind of low on waves. Some direction. Now let's switch, try to do the flamethrower here. I don't know if I even have anything, I think we have one wave. I think both sides have one wave left. I think we're, like, slightly one wave behind. We really need to cap that point. That'll give us an additional wave. Otherwise, this will be the last wave of this round. Get in. To the cap point. One thing that's cool about the flamethrower is you can bounce the stuff around. Nice spots. You can bounce the stuff around corners, which is pretty cool. So it's a nice way of flushing people out of their defensive positions. grab here. Okay.
Get some fucking smoke cover deployed!
Kameraden, führen Sie eine Weltkarte.
Hey, guys, like right
there. Das Hauptquartier meldet Feinde bei Cäsar.
Well, they are out of respawns now, so... Is that the end of the hall? Oh, there we go. That was the last guy. Cool. I'm most valuable. Then you replay the round. Let's see if we can... None of these are really great for this map. I got a ton of supply. I should use when I switch. I'll probably do this one time.
Then.
See how it goes. Basically light them all up when they come through the middle there. Where they all are. Come on up. Far. Flamethrower is really fun. Not very good for long-range engagements, but for the you know, most of the maps have at least some urban environment in it, so.
Give me that Kong!
I think I actually fired myself. Switch. Let's go to regular guy. We'll do that, and we'll do that, and we'll do that. This is regular bolt action rifle, rifleman guy. So we'll see how this works out. Again, not too good with the bolt action. So, really gotta line it up and hit him. I think I hit his flamethrower tank actually. They only have one more left, though. So. Got him.
That's an enemy!
They die, like, right on the other side of that. Probably not step into the fire. Just saying. Yeah. I'm alright with that. I have all the supply I'm not using though. I'll go heavy kit.
Hauptquartier meldet unsere Männer sich an Wärter.
Should be pretty good because they don't have any waves left. Small magazine.
Enemy down!
I don't like that weapon too much, to be honest. Dude, I got actually I can get more stuff here. I kinda want that. That's exciting. Rifle grenade. I want that.
Let's go, legs!
Hey. that was worth it. I like the rifle grenade, it's fun. Oof, I think I blew myself up. Alright, I reinforced this. Well, hopefully the- okay, good, they took him out. That was a fun weapon, though. I like that. I like that a lot. So we win. I'm MVP. Alright, well, you can't have a World War II game without doing D-Day, so that's the map we'll do next. Despite my complaining about the bolt action rifle, they killed me. Alright, so let's do... Boy, it's not even on there. More scenarios, please. Oh, really? Alright. Well, let's just do a manual then. Alright, so we'll do the offensive. No, we'll do the... Yeah, we'll do the offensive because invasion, you only respawn. You get one spawn per capture, so that's not as exciting. So we'll do dog red. I think I'm gonna play in Germans at the time. I'll switch to the Americans. That'll be fine. Alright, well, let's beat him. Oh, what do I want to do? Let's do... Here, let's do this. We'll do the Garen. That'll be fun. We'll switch classes on this side, too, because I would like to do the BAR and the Thompson at some point.
All right. HQ says we need to get rid of those German positions. We'll hit them one at a time, work our way back, and destroy their communications. That's bring your radios for support.
Nope.
Get ready.
No.
Get to work.
Excuse me, Infamy. I'm gonna try. Well, that was very anticlimactic. Basically, have 5 waves or 10 minutes to cap the first point, so. Even though I gotta fire my weapon. Time. That needs to kill me. But at least I got to hear the thing here. Alright. Nothing messing around. We gotta get in there. I think the major difference between this and Insurgency is because of the way the weapons are, most of them are semi-automatic or bolt action. With, you know, basically the submachine gun and machine gun differences, but creates a lot more tension. The reload times are way longer, so it just results in a, you know, a different feel than the other game. Let's see. Am I in the wrong place again? I am. Alright. No wonder there's nobody up here. Oh god, they got it. Alright, time to switch. Let's go support so I can do the BAR. Smoke. And then I'll do the assault class with the Thompson. That must be it. It's luck.
Shit, I'm...
You can see that your spawn point progressively moves up as you cap more things. Obviously moves the action.
Go.
class with the Thompson. So I'm gonna drop that for smoke grenades, so I can afford it. If I get one more supply, I'll get a sling. Here's the sniper rifle. Happened too. I think we got some friendlies. Oh, I did earn my one new supply, so I'm gonna grab that sling. Earn supply from capturing objectives, destroying the enemy, stuff like that. Come on, guys, cap that thing. In the bunkers. I have no idea when I'm gonna run into people here. Cool. Two new supply. Give me that, and give me... Probably the reason why no one followed me. Yeah, I totally got turned around.
Asshole! Holy shit!
Watch my back! I'm reloading!
Go the same way I went last time, didn't I?
We're doing a bombing run! Bomber's coming!
They're doing a bunker bomber that'll penetrate. Got a lot of people in here, so we should cap this pretty quick.
We're good! We got it!
It's like half the team's in there. Alright, one more to go. They have no more waves. So we should be able to take them out because they can't respawn. Not strong. There they are.
Hey, I'm reloading here! But they have no waves, so let me switch to the engineer so I can get explosives to blow this thing up.
So let me get my sling, my that, and that should be good. Like I said, they don't have any more respawns, so we should be able to take them out fairly easily. As soon as these bots get their act together and actually go towards the objective instead of screwing around in the bunkers. Good lord. Spawn like way far away. Yep, there we go. We got it. So he destroyed the radio, so we won that. Well, there you go. That is Day of Infamy. Like I said before, I think it's a good upgrade to, or not necessarily an upgrade, but different enough from Insurgency to warrant a purchase if you're into the Insurgency-style gameplay. Each of the maps are very detailed, beyond what you would expect for a mod. In addition to that, the uniforms are appropriate, and also the weapons create a different feeling game. You know, the use of bolt-action rifles and the extended reloading time and a lot of semi-automatic weapons just has a different feel than Insurgency does. So it definitely evokes more of a World War II feel into it. Has a lot of different classes that you can play as. Each has a very specific role that's appropriate for the weapons that they have. You know, you have short-range assault, medium-range riflemen, officers that can call in support, flamethrowers for urban areas, engineers for explosives to take care of objective locations, machine gunners and snipers for defense. So a lot of different options there depending on what your play style is. The AI is just okay. Sometimes they engage you very accurately from very far away, and sometimes they'll be standing right in front of you and not shoot at you. So it's very inconsistent. Although the cooperative campaigns against a ton of AI enemies are fun online, as are the rest of the game modes that are mostly carried over from Insurgency. The weapon balance is pretty good. You know, the automatic weapons are bad. You know, you can't use a submachine gun when you're at range, and you can't use the machine gun unless you're on a bipod, the heavy ones. So there is a lot of trade-off, and as long as you play what your role is, you'll, you know, excel in the game. Like I said, this is different enough to stand alone from Insurgency because of the map quality, the different classes and weapons that they have to evoke the World War II atmosphere in it. So it is a recommended title, especially if you enjoy the style of first-person shooter that Insurgency is. That's all I have for today. Until next time, bye now.